Welcome to Sunday morning meditations put on by the St. Margaret of Antioch Anglican Church in Belmont and the St. Jerome Mission in Gonzales. I am Canon Ronald Branch, priest in charge of the parish, welcoming you to Sunday morning meditations. Today, our readings are taken from proper 15 or 16, proper 16, form B. Let us pray. O God, the love of unity and author of peace, to know you is eternal life, to serve you is perfect freedom. Defend us, your servants, from all assaults of the enemy, that we may trust in your defense and not fear the power of any adversary, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Lord God, almighty and everlasting Father, you have brought us in safety to this new day. Preserve us with your mighty power, that we may not fall into sin nor be overcome by adversity. And in all we do, direct us to the fulfilling of your purpose, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Ecclesiastic, proper 16. Grant, O merciful God, that your church, being gathered together in unity by your Holy Spirit, may show forth your power among all peoples to the glory of your name, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Reading is taken. Reading is taken from Joshua 24. Verses 1 to 2a and 14 to 18. Joshua gathered all the tribes of Israel to Shechem and summoned the elders, the heads, the judges, and the officers of Israel. And they presented themselves before God. And Joshua said to all the people, "Thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, now therefore, revere the Lord and serve him in sincerity and in faithfulness. Put away the gods that your ancestors served beyond the river and in Egypt and serve the Lord. Now, if you are unwilling to serve the Lord, choose this day whom you will serve, whether the gods your ancestors served in the region beyond the river, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you are living. But as for me and my household, we will serve the Lord." Then the people answered, "Far be it from us that we should forsake the Lord to serve other gods. For it is the Lord our God who brought us and our ancestors up from the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery, and who did those great signs in our sight. He protected us along all the way that we went, and among all the peoples through whom we passed. And the Lord drove out before us all the peoples, the Amorites who lived in the land. Therefore, we also will serve the Lord, for he is our God." The word of the Lord.
Psalm 34, verses 15 to 22. The eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and his ears are open to their cry. The face of the Lord is against those who do evil, to root out the remembrance of them from the earth. The righteous cry, and the Lord hears them, and delivers them from all their troubles. The Lord is near to the brokenhearted, and will save those whose spirits are crushed. Many are the troubles of the righteous, but the Lord will deliver him out of all of them. He will keep safe all his bones. Not one of them shall be broken. Evil shall slay the wicked, and those who hate the righteous will be punished. The Lord ransoms the life of his servants, and none will be punished who trust in him. Ephesians chapter 6, verses 10 to 20. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his power. Put on the whole armor of God, so that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For our struggle is not against the enemies of blood and flesh, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers of this present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, so that you may be able to withstand on the evil day, and having done everything, to stand firm. Stand therefore, and fasten the belt of truth around your waist, and put on the breastplate of the righteous. As shoes for your feet, put on whatever will make you ready to proclaim the gospel of peace. With all of these, take the shield of faith, with which you will be able to quench all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Pray in the Spirit at all times in every prayer and supplication. To that end, keep alert and always persevere in supplication for all the saints. Pray also for me, so that when I speak, a message may be given to me to make known with boldness the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chains. Pray that I may declare it boldly as I must speak. The word of God.
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. John chapter 6, reading verses 56 through 69. Glory to Christ our Savior. Jesus said, "Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me, and I in them. Just as the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so whoever eats me will live because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, not like that which your ancestors ate and they died. But the one who eats this bread will live forever." He said these things while he was teaching in the synagogues at Capernaum. When many of his disciples heard this, they said, "This teaching is difficult. Who can accept it?" But Jesus, being aware that his disciples were complaining about it, said to them, "Does this offend you? Then what if you were to see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before? It is the Spirit that gives life. The flesh is useless. The words that I have spoken to you are spirit and life. But among you, there are some who do not believe. For Jesus knew from the first who were the ones that did not believe and who was the one that would betray him. And he said, "For this reason, I have told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted by the Father." Because of this, many of his disciples turned back and no longer went about with him. So Jesus asked the 12, "Do you also wish to go away?" Simon Peter answered him, "Lord, to whom can we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have come to believe and know that you are the Holy One of God." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to Christ our Lord.
Some years ago, I was working in the district of San Gandhi and was called to a house that had been transformed into a nursery. The name of the nursery was Choices. And in that nursery, there were many young girls who brought their babies, first to learn how to feed the child, how to hold the child, first to understand what we had to do as mother. And I never found out why we need to place choices. But in reminiscing, I could foretell that these girls had made a choice, and this was the result. So they called it Choices. The readings today invite us to make decisions, to make a choice. In the very first reading, Joshua is giving his last words to his people. He's about to ride off into the sunset after serving for a long time. And last words are always very interesting words. Joshua had come to realize that the people that he was serving in that time no longer looked back on the past, but were charting their own course according to what seemed modern to them. And so he called them together at Samaria and spoke to them. And he brings his whole speech to an interesting end when he says to them that if they went back and denied the God who had brought them out of slavery into freedom, the God who had done so much for their ancestors and for them, he wanted them to know, as for him and his household, it will serve the Lord. This is the last time he's going to be addressing them, and he wants to leave that message with them. They respond to him as though they understood what God had done for them in the past, was doing for them in the present, and was likely to do for them in the future. And they said with their lips that they will serve the Lord. The people there and then made a choice. And that is what life is about. Making choices. You see, we can choose or sin, but we do not choose the consequences. Making choices. Reaching a decision is again emphasized in the gospel story. For in it, Jesus tries to convince his disciples about what he meant when he said, "I am the bread of life." Many of them were discussing among themselves, "How can this man be any bread of life come down from heaven?" They were joining with many people who were turning their backs away from Jesus. Those who used to follow him, those who were enthralled by his miracles, as he spoke about his being the bread of life, they began to disperse, to turn their backs and to say many things about him. And so Jesus, not wasting time, confronts his disciples with the question, "What about you, disciples? What about you, Matthew? What about you, Thomas? What about you, Peter and Andrew and Nathaniel? Do you not want to leave too?" He gave them a choice. Their answer was, to whom shall we go? For we believe that you are indeed the Messiah. So they remained, even though many of the followers were leaving, they remained faithful to God. And then they're reading from Ephesians, the epistle, talks to us about again making a decision. A decision where you live your life in the Spirit. Where you are prepared to put on the armor of God. Realizing that the battle that we are up against is not flesh and bone, but is a spiritual battle. And in that spiritual battle, Paul, who has been through many experiences, says to the people at Ephesus, put on the armor of God. Put on the girdle of truth. The breastplate of righteousness, the helmet of salvation, walk with the sword, the word of the Lord, and shod their feet with the gospel of peace. It's Paul giving to the people at Ephesus advice to live their lives in the Spirit, and in doing so, to put on the armor of God. When you put on the armor of God, you don't take it off. Like a true soldier, you are always in the battle and prepared for the battle. For over and over, the enemy will try his very best to get you to go his way. Because you have decisions to make. You have a choice to make. On what grounds do you make your choices? How do you reach your decisions? Do you put these things in your prayers before God? Do you go back, having read the scriptures, and see what God did to deliver his people out of the darkness of Egypt? Do you look at what is going on across the world at present to see how the tide is pulling people away from God? What decision do you make? As a disciple for Christ, you too are asked, as Jesus asked the disciples, if they wanted to go their own way. For sometimes, many say that they are going God's way, and they still find the going rough and tough. But what is your prayer life like? How are you wearing the armor of God against the enemy? What is the state of your worship? How do you meditate on God's word? For it is these things that strengthen us in the desert of our trials. to find an oasis of peace, love and harmony, and a trust in God that will help us to make a decision that will always be on the grounds of what would please God and not man. May God continue to bless us all, and may we, having to confront decisions from day to day, make the right decisions, guided by the power of the Holy Spirit in our undertaking. Amen.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I worship Your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing Your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Your holy name. You're rich in love and You're slow to anger. Your name is great and Your heart is kind. For all Your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like this. Worship Your holy name. Bless You, time has come. Still my soul will sing Your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forevermore, forevermore. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I worship Your. your holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, worship your holy name. Jesus, I will worship your holy name. Worship your holy name.
Give thanks to God, our Father, for all His gifts so freely bestowed upon us. For the beauty and wonder of creation, we thank you, Lord. For all that is gracious in the lives of men and women, revealing the image of Christ, we thank you, Lord. For our daily food, for our homes and families and friends, we thank you, Lord. For minds to think and hearts to love, we thank you, Lord. For health, strength, and skill to work, and for leisure to rest and play, we thank you, Lord. For those who are brave and courageous, patient in suffering and faithful in adversity, we thank you, Lord. For all who pursue peace, justice, and truth, we thank you, Lord. For the communion of saints in all times and places, we thank you, Lord. Above all, we give you thanks for the great mercies and promises given to us in Christ Jesus, our Lord. To Him be praise and glory with you, O Father, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. today we had reading for us, it's Jennifer John and Carice John Thomas. We give thanks to Almighty God for all those who have listened to this program, and trust that what they have heard will be able to inculcate in their lives, so that now walking in the armor of God, they'll be able to be protected from the evil that may attack them. Grant us wisdom, grant us courage, and through it all, may we do what is right and pleasing in your sight, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen. Please have a spirit-filled week and continue to read the Word of God and to be guided by that Word of God to get the full benefit from what God has provided for us through His Word. I'm Karen Ronald Branch, thanking you for listening to Sunday Morning Meditations, coming to you through the St. Margaret of Antioch Anglican Church in Belmont, and our mission at St. Jerome in Gonzales. Have a spirit-filled week all.
How precious.